Hi folks, we've got a job to do today that I've been putting off for far too long. I'm going to replace the rear differential pinion seal on the Salisbury type axle. I've got a new drive flange to go on there as well, just in case the lands that the seal runs on are actually worn. And there is the new seal itself. I'm not quite sure what type I've got in there. It could be a leather type, it could be the rubber type if it's been replaced later on. Right, this is what the Salisbury axle looks like. As you can see, this one's been leaking for a little while. One of those jobs that's needed doing for a couple of years since I bought the vehicle. And first thing I'm going to do is give the differential a good clean, and then when I've done the job I'll be able to see if there's any leaks or not. And just for comparison, that there's a Rover axle, which is obviously on the front of this one. Fairly typical for a 109, but a lot of shorter base Land Rovers have them on the back as well. Again, just before we start, this is the leather type of seal, just for comparison. Both the same size, do the same job, but it's reckoned that these modern rubber ones last a little bit longer. So I'll keep this one as a spare. Never know when you might need it. So now we're ready to remove the rear prop shaft. We're only going to disconnect one end and then bungee it up out of the way. You can do it with two 9/16 spanners, or to make your life easier, I think these are about 12 quid, you can buy the proper prop shaft nut tool. Again, 9/16, well worth having. That was a bit loose. Okay, so just be careful as you get the last bolt out. These things ain't light. There should be enough movement on the prop when we push it back that way and then lift it up. Okay, just a quick explanation of why we're going to mark the pinion shaft to the drive flange nut. On the Salisbury axle, so this is a bit different to the Rover and ENV types, on the Salisbury axle you've got a crushable spacer in there, and I believe that sets the preload on the bearings, so it's quite important that the nut goes back at exactly the same tightness, shall we say, so you don't torque it up like you might on the Rover axle. Instead, you just punch mark the shaft and the nut and align the two. So that's exactly what I'm going to do now. Okay, we'll just save putting all the stress of trying to undo this nut through the diff and the half shafts. I'm sure you can probably do this without, but it also stops the vehicle trying to roll back and forwards. I've made a little tool which bolts onto the drive flange, a couple of stainless M8 bolts in there, and it just puts the stress through that straight to the ground, as it were. I'll get a breaker bar in there, hopefully get the nut undone. To be honest, I can't remember if you should drain the oil from the diff first. I think you should. I changed the oil recently, so I don't really want to drain it all. So I'm just going to put a bucket underneath it, let what needs to drain off, if it does drain off, and I'll just jack the front up, put a couple of stands under there, and that'll stop the oil running forwards while I'm working. the drive flange off the pinion, you're going to need a puller. Easiest way to do it. A good one like this, Draper one, just 2-leg 4-inch puller, you're looking at about 20 quid, so they're well worth having if you haven't got one already. Okay, you could probably have got this one off with a hammer, but you know, in a drift. But this way you don't damage anything. It is perfectly normal, by the way, for the pinion shaft to then become quite sloppy, because of course you're taking the nut off, taking the preload off those taper roller bearings. And now you can see why I've got the bucket underneath. So yeah, you should drain the oil, but in this case I'm just not bothering, because I can top it up again later. It's fresh oil anyway. In mind, but it's off. Right, well, the reason for the leak is immediately obvious, and you can see that the lens where the seal actually runs, it's actually quite badly scored. If I mic that up, you could measure a fair bit of difference on that. And also there's a little bit of rust pitting there, so I think the vehicle's been laid up for some time during its life. This area here, I think that's a sort of attempt at a mud shield. It was all rammed full of mud as well, so you can see why the new drive flange has got an improved version of the mud shield, big dished shield on it. I've checked the two, measured the two drive flanges against each other, and they're both identical, so all the important bits are the same. Most importantly, and I was concerned about this because of the bent prop shaft incident, I was concerned that it might have caused the drive flange to come loose on the pinion shaft. I was concerned that it would have damaged the splines, but as you can see, they're in really good order, pretty much as good as the new one, so no concerns there at all. I've let the oil drain out of the diff as much as I can, and I've just jacked the front up on stand so that the oil runs back now and I can carry on working on it. Anticipating having trouble getting the seal out, because it's been in there a long time by the looks of it, I've made up this little slide hammer. Bit of bright steel bar, which I use for an extension bar for drills, and a bit of welding rod, because that's pretty strong, bent to shape, clamped in there. And a 6mm or M6 rather bolt through the end, lump of bronze which is nice and heavy. Hopefully won't need to work too hard at it, but if I do, that should get it out. Another way that people get the seals out is that they drill a couple of holes and put 2 self-tapping screws in and prise them out like that, but I think this is slightly less sort of invasive. Right, well, unfortunately my slide hammer method didn't work, wouldn't budge it at all. So I had to use the backup, which I wasn't so keen to do, and that is to drill 2 little pilot holes through the seal. If you have a look at the diagram in the Haynes manual for the Salisbury axle, you can see where you need to drill without damaging the casting itself. What I've done is just using the mole grips on there, a few taps with a hammer, and it started to move. So hopefully it'll come out now. There she goes. Well, there you go. Got the little blighter out in the end. Does look fairly worn, to be honest with you. We're about ready to install the new seal now. That's the type we took out with the leather seal in it. Quite important you get it the right way around. Now on the new seal, you've actually got a little directional arrow. You might just be able to see there. So with the vehicle moving forwards, obviously, just look at which way your diff turns. It's as easy as that. But basically you want it with that lip facing inwards, so that pressure behind it will expand the seal and make it seal tighter on the pinion. So with this type, you want it with that lip there facing out of the differential casing, and this side facing the inside of the axle, if that makes sense. So with this one, see that lip there, that side facing inside, this side facing outside the axle. I've actually cleaned this off just so you can see. The new seal has these kind of little chamfered or chevron like lines to direct oil away from the edge of the seal. I'll put some fresh grease around that before I put it back on. It's also good practice to put a bit of jointing compound around the outside of the seal, or as I've done, you can put it on the axle casing, which saves, you know, getting it all over your fingers while you're trying to put the seal in. Well, I should also have said I've got a bit of pipe here. It just happens to be the same diameter of the edge of the seal. A bit of old signpost, I think. And don't worry, it was legitimately acquired. So I've put a bead of jointing compound, sealant, gasket sealer basically around the outside, making sure I've got this the right way around. I'm going to just offer it up. I've greased the channel inside, packed it, and then we're going to try and just tap it in to start with, get it square, and then we'll finish off with a bit of tube. I'm just trying to square it up because it started to drift in slightly at an angle, so before it goes too far, it's this edge that's protruding most. Right, I reckon that's pretty good now. I think that's pretty much as far as it's going to go. And as you can see, got the new sealing plate right. In fact, it did drift back just slightly further in the end. Once I got it pretty much all the way, I just got a brass drift and carefully tapped all the way around the edge until I got it right home. You'll know when the seal's home because the noise it makes will change as it's contacting the casting fully. Yeah, quite pleased with that. So the next thing is to fit the new drive flange. So I'm just going to grease the splines. I'll probably grease the inside of the new drive flange, and I'm going to warm it up. I'll stick it on top of the radiator for 5 minutes. It should fit easier. Well, believe it or not, this is quite an efficient way of heating this up. Not in energy terms, but it does it quickly, if you see what I mean. I've cleaned the splines on the diff pinion shaft itself, and with this heated up and some grease applied, hopefully it'll just slide on. I don't really want to have to, or rather I want to try and minimise the force, if you see what I mean. Puts less stress on everything then, as I assemble it. Right, so here's the new dry flange. It's pretty hot, I can just about hang on to it. I've greased the inside of the splines, the shaft as well, and the outside where the seal runs, just lightly, which will help it along. So now we're just going to gently offer it up and hope that it fits. As good as it's going to get, it's pushed the shaft that way slightly, so now we'll put the nut on. Once tightened up, it should bring it back. I've greased the threads, and I have measured the new drive flange, which is exactly the same length. Important to that being that the nut should finish off with the two marks aligned and be at the right torque setting. Because if it were a different length, the marks wouldn't align at the right time, if you see what I'm getting at. So I need to get the 32mm socket on there and the breaker bar. So there you go, this is the new dry flange fitted. It feels okay and it's tightened up to the right amount. I just let it cool down and then check it again. That can sometimes have an effect on things. So I'm going to just let the front axle back down now, check for leaks, and then top up the diff. So now we fill up the axle and wait and see if anything comes out the bottom. Hopefully not. Right, well, I'm torquing up the prop shaft bolts at the moment. Recommended torque is 30 to 38 pounds foot. But I can't even get a 30 pound foot of torque on the wrench before it feels like they're stripping out. So I'm not very impressed. So what I'm going to do is take the bolts out, try some different nuts I've found for them, and see if we can get anywhere near then. But if I'm not happy, I'll order up some high tensile ones and replace them with those. Right, well, I'm just in the process of changing the prop shaft bolts over. You can see I've used the same bolt itself, but I've used some different nuts that I found. Nice 16th nylock still, but they're just slightly longer. So you've got a bit more thread. So we actually reach the torque setting, 30 pound foot, before it feels like the bolt's stretching. Or it just didn't feel right before, and the nut was rounding off. So that's satisfactory now. I know it's not an aeroplane, but it's such a crucial part, you might as well make sure it's right. Something else I've been doing, I've fitted mud flaps all round. And I never really finished the, what I was calling the Rusty Repairs series of videos, because I did the back brakes and then managed to lose all of the footage. But I did the back brakes. And I've also fitted a couple of fire extinguishers. So for example, we've got one on the back door with me, little camping table, and one in the front as well. So the rear prop's now properly torqued up, though I've had to change another bolt. You can actually see what was happening to them there. Made out of cheese, I think.
So I've torqued up the prop shaft bolts. It hasn't leaked overnight, so we'll go for a little test drive and we'll see if it's done the trick. Of course it's leaked from everywhere else, but if there ain't all under it, there ain't all in it. Okay, well, just been for about a 10 mile test drive, up to about 50 miles an hour. A little warm through, no leaks. So, lovely journey to do tomorrow. Fingers crossed, should be alright. So that's how you change Salisbury diff seal. I'm sure there are other ways of doing it, but this has worked for me. Hope the video is useful, and thanks for watching.